Hi everyone, welcome to the tutorial for Hidden Markov Model. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to infer discrete dynamics from noisy measurements. This tutorial is divided into two parts. In part one, you will work on a Hidden Markov Model with binary latent variable either 0 or 1, and Gaussian observations. You will first build up this model, generate some sample sequences of states and measurements, and then visualize them. Then we will go through some exercises to get a sense of how you will forget the past states over time because the world is changing, and how to increase your confidence of inference from data. After that, you will complete the forward inference of a random state sequence from noisy data it generates, and compare your inference states with the ground truth to see if the inference is correct and under which conditions it's correct. In part two, we will focus on the example of Poisson spiking neurons mentioned in the intro lecture. Part two is optional, and please make sure you have finished part one before proceeding. The code of this part is provided by the intro speaker, Dr. Sean Ascola. In this part, you will go through how to estimate the model parameters from data using the expectation maximization algorithm and visualize how EM algorithm can monotonically increase the data likelihood. Then you will check if the EM algorithm has recovered the true model parameters by visualization. Okay, let's go. First, let me briefly overview the Hidden Markov Model. A Hidden Markov Model is composed of a Markov chain, which you cannot directly observe, and a observation model which produces noisy measurements of the latent states. In Hidden Markov Model, we acquire information about the latent states from the measurements they generate and infer what the states are. The Markov property tells us that the current latent state xt only depends on the previous one, and the probability to jump from one state to another at next time is specified by the element of a transition matrix A. The matrix element Aij represents the probability to transition from state I to state J. For example, if A is an identity matrix, we will stay at the current state forever. If A has non-zero off-diagonal elements, then we will have a possibility to jump to other states at next time, which results in a much richer dynamics. In neuroscience, we often think a system like a single neuron or population of neurons is transitioning between a set of discrete states. For example, we believe a system is switching between the active state and inactive state, or between awake state and a sleep state. And we also believe the neural activities are generated from these discrete dynamics. Then we can try to infer the discrete states from measurements like electric signals or calcium imaging signals. Here, Hidden Markov Model is a simple yet powerful class of models to describe these latent switching dynamics. Different from the sequential probability ratio test or SPRT we covered in tutorial 1. Now, the latent state is no longer fixed over time. Instead, we have a full dynamics. So, in Hidden Markov Model, we don't have the chance to increase our confidence by making more measurements. Instead, what we do now is to predict the current latent state from previous state, and then combine that prediction with the current measurement or new data point to make a complete inference. Basically, the forward inference of Hidden Markov Model and common filter in tutorial 3 is a repeated procedure of making prediction from the data at hand now, and then correcting our prediction with new evidence. Imagine when you are predicting without evidence, you always increase your variance, but you can decrease it again by combining new data. This is the key idea of inference in Hidden Markov Model.